It has probably been a month since the last updated class video, and usually, I'll be honest, these don't do great in views, but they are kind of important. I get asked all the time, what is the best X, Y, Z, what is the class I'm using, and this video will help you out with that, okay? Not only am I going to show you what I use, what the best is, I'm going to explain why I'm using these certain things, because a lot of people don't understand, it seems like. For example, people love using stims. I don't think stims are good. I really don't. They have their place in respawn. In search, though, not a great tactical. So first, before you're playing search, always use dead silence, okay? Almost always. You can make a case for, like, recon drone, but if you want to play search decently, dead silence is your best friend. It's one of the fastest charge rates in the game. It's one of the most useful abilities, and you can just be a non-stop rushing maniac if you have a good round with it. So always use dead silence. Secondly, my favorite killstreaks personally are UAV, precision airstrike, and the VTOL jet. You can mix and match some of these. Cluster strikes, not bad, not great. Hellstorm or cruise missile, I'm not good with this. It seems to just not be anywhere near as good as it used to be, so I prefer to use precision airstrike. At the very least, if it's not going to kill anybody, it might send a body flying into the air, which is fun to laugh at. You know, I enjoy that. Loadouts. Five classes I want to go over here, okay? Five classes. The Tryhard SMG is the MP5. Start with this one. Now, almost all of my classes, I like to run the perks EOD, restock, shrapnel. This is because a lot of people use explosives, mainly Bettys and Claymores. Or you're getting grenades thrown at you, right? Restock to replenish my own frag and my own stun, and shrapnel for an extra frag at the start, which is helpful as well to pick up one or two kills. Search and Destroy is a game mode about picking people off. And then if you die, hopefully you can trade. So if you're able to use extra lethals to pick somebody off early in the game, that automatically gives you an advantage, right? Whether it's your team advantage of a 5v6, then you have an extra player, or it's an advantage for you to then push through the route that you're going and flank on the other players, which is an advantage just to go get more kills yourself and open up a route for yourself. I use a combat knife on almost all my classes as well. That's because I like to start with a knife out and I sprint further and a little bit faster. Move speed wise, it's just helpful for rushing, okay? Now, the MP5. Monolithic is always good. Always, okay? I see a lot of people who don't use it. I was confused for a while. It's always good. The only reason you're not going to use this is if you're playing competitive a fair amount. Monolithic's not allowed. It's banned, so you can keep it off then, okay? If you want to get used to or be used to using the class that you're going to be forced to use a CDL. I like Merc Foregrip personally because it is enough recoil control that it matters, but it also affects hipfire accuracy, which I think is good for pretty much every weapon. Ammunition, 10mm rounds. I still think this is probably better just because of the mid-range fights you get in with the MP5. This isn't bad. 45 is not bad. I'd say it's probably more of a respawn thing, though. And even then, not going to say it's 100% worth. Stipple grip tape, ADS, and sprint to fire speed. Always good for an SMG, any close-range weapon, frankly. I use the GI mini reflex. This is because I suck with the iron sight of the MP5. If you are good with it, don't worry about the reflex at all. You could throw on a different barrel if you want. You could throw on one of the stocks here if you think you want more ADS speed, or you want ADS speed and move speed, be really, really fast and aggressive with it. Some people really like that. I would probably personally use sleight of hand. Where the hell that is? There it is. Because sleight of hand is just, this gun's reload speed is kind of slow. And even though in search, it doesn't matter as much as respawn because you're not going to fight people back to back to back to back to back to back, it's still pretty helpful. All right. So I would probably, if I didn't have my reflex on, I'd have a regular iron sight and sleight of hand. Going to the Tryhard Rifle. Same class, same perk setup, same everything here. Now, this does change. I want you to know, based on the map we're playing, I say where me and friends, whatever, this will change around. Mainly, if I'm playing by myself and my teammates are just dying nonstop, I have to put on Ghost on any of these classes, frankly, because they're just going to be feeding UAVs to the other team, and I can't really do much. I have to shoot the UAVs down every time or just run Ghost. So I might have to change that. Also, under the shrapnel list, I might have to switch it up to Battle Hardened. It's almost always shrapnel or Battle Hardened, unless it's a sniper class that it's amped, or an overkill class, but I don't overkill. Don't like it. Just don't like it. So, knife as well. Always EOD. I don't think I ever change EOD. Pretty much never in search. So, under this, you can change this up a little bit as well. If you like iron sights, okay, and you can get rid of the reflex. Almost always, I think the Grenadier Barrel is the best. Almost always, again, Merc Foregrip, the best. And almost always, Stippled Grip Tape. Those three things, I will almost always keep the same on this gun. The two things you can switch up, in my opinion, is knocking off the optic or changing the stock. The best stocks out there are the Forged Tack. If you're on like bigger maps, mid-range maps, long-range maps, this is better. If you're on more mid-range, small-range maps, you can rock no stock and you're perfectly fine. I love no stock. I would say that the Forged Tack is just a bit more universal though. So, and then you can take off your sight and you can have, you can do more ammunition if you wanted. Different ammunition. You could run sleight of hand as well on this, or a lot of people probably would prefer to have a compensator or monolithic suppressor, one of those two. Either you're reducing the recoil to land more shots, or you're improving the damage range. It's up to you on that. What do you want to do? I don't really care. I think both are totally viable options. This is just kind of the go-to stock M4 I use when I need to use a tryhard gun, you know? Moving down, the tryhard shotgun. I'm sure you all know the 725, okay? Now, EOD restock shrapnel, same thing again. Once in a while, on these rushing classes like this or the SMG, I will have to change my stun to a smoke as well, depending on the map and the route that I'm using. But not every map. You know, Hackney Yard's a great example. Almost always use a stun on that map. Where if I'm playing Petrograd, I almost always use a smoke. So it just depends on the map and the route, really. For some reason, this gun is broken with a sawed-off barrel. It seems to be glitched, but the gun's range is crazy, crazy, crazy far. I don't know if it's the wider pellet spread, whatever it may be. It just has crazy far range, even though it says it reduces the range. So I don't understand it. I think it's a glitch. Most people I talk to think it's a glitch. I use the sawed-off barrel, a choke. Some people like the tactical suppressor, or I'm not the monolithic, I'm sorry. I wouldn't use that. That improves damage range, but it doesn't improve actual, like, tighter pellet spread to make more of a focused shot. So, I prefer choke. I like the 1 milliwatt laser. 5 is technically better, okay? But it also gives away where you are, and that drives me nuts. So, I don't like using that as much. You don't need an underbarrel. None of this really matters. It will improve your ADS speed and recoil control, but there's no recoil really with a shotgun, and your ADS speed is not, I would say, irrelevant, but not extremely important. Never use slug rounds, by the way. Those suck. Those suck. You can use a stock if you want. Nothing really crazy about that. You'll have your move speed moved up a bit. You're not going to ADS still most of the time. You want the Tempest Slim Grip. This is your ADS speed and your sprint to fire speed. Mainly the sprint to fire speed matters, okay? Mainly the sprint to fire speed. And then perk, I use sleight of hand. And that's because this gun only has 2 shots. So you go boom, boom, and you try to reload it as quickly as possible. Helpful in respawn, helpful in search as well. So that's the tryhard shotgun. The best shotgun in the game by far. Now I'm going to move on to my fun SMG. This isn't as tryhard, but I love the P90. And a lot of you guys ask what P90 class I'm using. All right. So I like monolithic suppressor, forged tack, retribution, stippled grip tape again. Double it up. And then fly strap. I'm kind of like stuck on this. I don't know. I think ADS speed is good. But at the same time, I like being able to pull my gun up faster, which is sprint to fire speed. And I like to be able to strafe kind of quick, which is like your ADS move speed. So I don't know. I think this is better. This gun's weakness kind of is the ADS speed of it. But I still love this SMG. I think this is a very good SMG, but it's not the best. It's not an MP5. But it is very good, and it's very fun. So I like to have that on like my top roster to use. Most of these I would never use unless I'm really trying to win, or I don't really have any other answer. And that's because the tryhard sniper class. Now this is, I'm going to say tryhard sniper, but it really isn't super tryhard. Truthfully, most people when they're tryharding are going to rock wherever the heck it is. Overkill. Where is it? I never use it, so I don't even know where to look for it. There it is, overkill. And they're going to run a 7.25 secondary or an MP5 secondary. Almost always people do this. I personally don't like doing that just because I love restock for 2 reasons. One, this is a thermal sniper. All right? This is a thermal sniper. I have everything on it to improve the ADS speed except the thermal scope. These barrels don't really matter. Your damage is fine on an HDR. I use the HDR and the AX50, but I usually use the HDR because it one-shots way more consistently. But because it's a thermal sniper, and I have the first thermal sight on it. I like this one the most, by the way. I use smoke grenades, and I can restock my smokes and keep throwing smokes over and over and over. And that lets me cover a lot of lines of sight throughout a round that I normally wouldn't be able to just, like, hard peek. As for a secondary, I mean, you can obviously go to the normal 357. Akimbos are good. I still think that a single one is way better because you can ADS and shoot at much longer distance, and it can kill in two shots anyway, so... Akimbo's fun. This is probably better, factually speaking. So you can change this around if you want. I am annoyed when people recognize my laser and I die, so I don't use certain lasers. I try to always use the 1 milliwatt. And I've also noticed when this is too focused, it gets hit markers more often because this gun was nerfed a while ago. So you can't get a one shot with it unless you hit at least like a pellet or two on the head. So having a wider spread to let one pellet or two pellets hit the head actually seems to be more beneficial. You don't want it too wide, but, like, you know, enough. We'll say enough. And this is the only class I will run amped on, by the way. Sniper class, whether you're overkilling or not, I will always run amped on my sniper class. Restock and EOD, pretty much unanimous. I always have a smoke on my thermal class. Depending on the map, offense or defense, I will switch between frag and claymore. So that's kind of the only difference. But those are the tryhard guns. Those are my tryhard guns. What I will use. I love to snipe. I wouldn't say sniping's too insanely tryhard. Like I said, I never overkill. I'm not that big of a bitch with it. But if I want to try to win, I'll use an MP5, an M4, or a 7.25. Also, at the same time, if somebody kills me too many times in a game with these weapons, I will put them on myself and try to kill them back because it annoys me. Frankly, it just annoys me. Either way, there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I tried to make it quick and clean for you, explain things that you might want to know. I do not run stims. Everyone likes stims. Stuns are too good. I'm sure you notice when you get stunned, you can't move for like ever. So why, I mean, in respawn, okay, stim's cool. Some maps, even a gas grenade is cool. Hackney Yard and Crash, I like gas grenades sometimes. I would never use snapshot. I would never use heartbeat sensor. I would never use flashes. Flashes are not as good as stuns. So stun, smoke, once in a while you can use a stim. On respawn, you can use it whenever. Gas grenade here and there as well. But mainly stun smoke, okay? Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I hope this helps out with your classes for Modern Warfare.